After only 6 months, the DPC ACP retired, Bob Ngobi, recommended me to police headquarters that he had seen that I am a hardworking officer and I would be able to fit in as officer in charge of Entebbe Police Station, OC Station. And police headquarters appointed me the OC Station of Entebbe, which means I was managing the police station, but I was also managing the outer posts. At that time, OC Station was doing that, dealing with internal discipline, deployments, you know, postings, you know, placements within the district. But I was also dealing with salaries, you know, I was dealing with leave, I was dealing with cleanliness of the barracks. OC Station was almost like, you know, everything. I was doing everything. And you can imagine that I didn't rest. I was not married, I was alone, and, you know, no girlfriend around, you know. So I really put all, everything in my work. Then later on, I was transferred to Apache, and then from Apache, I came to police headquarters. Now, at that time, police had a project under the British Council. Actually, it was under the Department of DFID, Department for International, yes, which was a British agency that was helping the police to be able to become a robust, you know, entity, and that is able to deliver its services in a professional manner. And one of the things they identified that we didn't have, coming from the history of the police up to that time, was that we lacked a connection with the people. That the police was only being hard and only looked at crime, but did nothing in terms of winning the hearts and soul of the people of the Republic of Uganda. So they recommended that we should start a community policing program, which is responsible for outcomes of improving relations. Now, a hunt was on to choose which officer in the Uganda police can really start a program of talking to people, you know, and joining them in crime prevention activities, letting the police be community-oriented, making the police to be with the people and feel they are all one, because all of us want peace, want, you know, security, want a crime-free society. If that can happen, that's what people desire, and that's what the police should desire. Now, they tossed so many names. I didn't know this was happening, and my name was among those. And I was late, I will not explain what took place or whatever, but briefly, there was a party, and a Muzungu had come from, we used to call him Muzungu, so you can excuse me. We used to joke with him, and he said, "No, don't call me Bernard Brown. I want to be called Muzungu." Yeah, so when he came over and started this program, and they were told there was a young man from Entebbe Police Station. Now, chance happened that there was a party organized to welcome one of the directors of CID, Chris Wachiza. I think that time he was not in CID. He was a legal, somebody in charge of legal and loans in the police. And another officer who was retiring called Seru. So it was organized on Mitiana Road in a place called Club Oasis. So I went there. I didn't know I was under kind of interview. And this gentleman, Bernard Brown, continued studying me. At that time, I was not drinking. He saw people drinking. I was not drinking. And what amazed him, because he told me later, after he had left this country, I asked him, "Why did you choose me?" Later, he realized that people were coming to talk to me, including senior people. Okay, he mentioned ACP Nabudere. He mentioned that time Yiga was in charge of the traffic at that time. He saw Madame Mwanga, who retired as AIGP. They were all coming to talk to me, and I was talking to them. And he wondered how a young officer, an ASP, would be talking to, what is it that was drawing them nearer to me? And he said he asked them, and they told him. But they had also known that in Entebbe, I was one person who thought that by being able to control crime in Entebbe, I was able to go to each department in government, because most government agencies were in Entebbe. I would go and talk to permanent secretaries, how they want us to provide services better than what we are doing. Our station was providing guard services to all government agencies in Entebbe. And I was not new to all of them. And it is from there that I learned from them that, no, we want police to do this. We want police that comes and talks to us. We want police that does this and this and this and this. You know, so I became, my orientation about police and what was expected of me changed from these senior government officials who are talking to me. So there was no doubt that my pathway was already, you know, being sharpened to go towards a community-oriented approaches. Now, when I joined police headquarters for community policing, I was sent to UK, to Stafford to be precise, where I studied crime prevention and community policing. And I think I was one of the first officers, if not the only officer. Yeah, this I'm sure of. I'm the only police officer who studied from that college. Okay? And when I came back, I started the program of community policing. Now, that was the background. I'm sorry it was long. But I can tell you that the trajectory of my rise came from that. Because immediately I came, I started radio programs. Now, people started hearing a young officer called Kasinje who cannot even speak Luganda. Okay? Later on, I started a program on the CBS in 1997 called Police No Muntu Wa Bulijjo. And people had Afande Kasinje, and I dragged another young officer who is now a commissioner called John Kamia. Okay? So we used to go to CBS from 11. The program was hosted by the late now, Mulindwa Mwonge. Okay? Then later on, I think when we went to another radio, we were joined by Sensua, okay? Bwanika, Sensua. And other people, Kagoro died, you know, the late Kagoro. And we started going, I started going to all TVs, you know, the TVs that, you know, television stations. That time there was a lady called Irene Kurabako. I think she's still around, Irene Kurabako. She had a program, a talk show. And on that talk show, she used to call people, you know, programs that relate with the people. I started also coming to the Irene Kurabako show. We started also having crime prevention clubs in the country, in Kampala. You know, people coming together, we're teaching them community policing and crime prevention. They had plays, they would act plays so that we can be able to prevent crime through plays. Started working with young people on the streets. Started going to every district in Uganda. I have been to each and every district in this country to be able to take the gospel of community policing and enjoining the local governments, you know, the people to work hand in hand with the police. I also went to public institutions. I went to universities. I would have public lectures in Makerere University, UCU Mukono, Nkozi Matters University, Uganda Matters University in Nkozi, MUBS. I went to all universities. So that definitely brought something to me. And since this was a new effort, the restructuring of the police also positively impacted on my rise. Because this community policing started as a desk. So ASP would. Then after some time, then I was appointed as an acting assistant commissioner of police in charge of community affairs. Okay? That means now I am in an office of an assistant commissioner, and yet I was a superintendent. That means I have to be quickly promoted senior superintendent. Now, I became a superintendent in 2001, and in 2002, the following year, I became senior superintendent of police. Remember, the office I'm sitting in is for assistant commissioner. Still, I'm one rank below assistant commissioner. In 2004, I was appointed assistant commissioner so that it can be commensurate with the office which I had. Now, that is when we had the Inspector General of Police, General Katumba Wamara. And they sat in the restructuring and they realized that the departments should be headed by a commissioner. Okay? Yes. And then the senior commissioners who were heads of directorates, a new rank was introduced called Assistant Inspector General of Police. So quickly, I was promoted to the rank of commissioner in 2005. SCP 2004? Okay. SP 2001, 2002 SSP, 2004 SCP, 2005 commissioner. So I am one of the cohort of the first people in police to put on the rank of commissioner of police. Then when General when General Kale Kaihura came, he again restructured the police and expanded on the directorates. And he, being from the background of political commissariat, he was a political commissar of the in the UPDF, and rightly he said there should be a chief political commissar in the police at the rank of Assistant Inspector General of Police. And I was the first CPC of the police. And I was appointed AIGP in 2009. Okay, after the restructuring process of 2008. Okay, so by that time, there was no rank of senior commissioner of police.